So, Michelle and I have known each other for over 14 years. She's been my best friend, and due to circumstances out of our control, whether she was with somebody, I was, we just never dated. And until about a year ago, and the stars aligned, I asked her out, and good God, she said yes. And here we are now. I've planned this since the museum date, which was our technically third date, but, you know, 14 years later. And I wanted to make it special, and I thought, what better way than a mutual love of art? I've been an artist for my entire life, and she really has an appreciation for it, and I thought I would paint some of my favorite memories of her and I. You know, I wanted to do it somewhere special, and we have the train trip coming up onto Cass Mountain, and I thought I would do it during the trip, if everything works out well. We'll see how this thing goes. We'll see how nervous I am. I know I'm probably going to be a wreck in front of her. She means that much to me. But we're going to do it, and we'll see what we got. I love the girl. I always have. Okay, entry one. It's been 6 months since I decided that I was going to ask Michelle to marry me. In that time, I have asked her parents' permission. I have asked Willow and Colby's permission. I have asked Chelsea and Brittany's permission. I am now about to ask Lacey and Dalton's permission. Everybody so far has been very approving and very excited about it. I'm nervous, you know. I won't go through it if they do not approve, or if they think I shouldn't. And I just wanted to get this all down as we go through this whole process and see what they say. So, fingers crossed. Okay. On the good news, bad news front. Update. I have not heard from Dalton. And that's disconcerting. On the plus side, I picked out their engagement ring. New update, talk to everybody. Everybody has given their blessing for me to ask Michelle to marry her. Now, how are we going about this? Good question. I've started a series of paintings. For those of you that don't know, I taught art and have been an artist for ever. And I've started a series of paintings based on two things. One, our history together, and two, the different styles of art that she likes. And each one is going to tell part of our history leading up to my proposal to her. And
and document these as we go. So starting now, big giant blank canvas. Step one, here we go.
Okay, this is the start of our first date. It's going to be a snowstorm and us walking together through the snowstorm, me being a complete absolute idiot because I was so nervous. Okay, first date painting I'm pretty happy with so far. Here's where we are. I have our silhouettes. I have a tree, and amidst the snowfall, I'm going to put some blossoms on the tree to signify the new beginning that we had on this first date. And damn it, no matter how hard I try, I never feel like it's good enough for my girl. I hope she likes them. Okay, first date is finished, I think. I just hope she likes it. Okay, well, I totally forgot to film the start of this one. This is the witch in the woods. Maybe called the spell. I don't know. I'll come up with that later. But this is going to be a history of ours, of Michelle putting a spell on me, saying that she was going to make me fall in love with her. Guess she's pretty good at that. Okay. Here's the final, hopefully final, of the Cast a Spell on You painting. That's what we've got here. A little bit of lightning over here, a tiny bit, is when we first touched, there was literally a spark. And that's so corny to say, but it literally happened. 15 years ago, neither one of us have even forgotten. So, I hope she likes this a lot. Okay, update. Down payment on the ring was done, finished, and I'll be picking it up this week, which means I will have it in time for the mountain trip, which is where I plan on proposing and have for quite a very long time. Things have just started to work out well, so I'm excited. Nervous as all hell, though. New update on the paintings. Where is it? There it is. That's the Aurora. Had to go full black canvas and then start bringing the color forward to get where it needs to be. And beside it, we have our first try at pop art. And this is going to be a collaboration of all the different things from Germantown, of the koi fish, that wonderful photograph I took of Michelle with the hat covering half her face, that iconic tower on the way into Germantown. I'm not sure what I'm doing out here yet, but we're getting there. Okay, another one almost done, I think. This is the first fight, pun intended, painting. It's of the Northern Lights, which she absolutely adores, and there's a big story behind that too, but just wanted to give her that painting. Okay, so this was the little ring sizer that I bought offline. We'll see how close I am, considering I put her ring on my pinky to measure it. Sly devil that I am. God, I hope I'm right. Well, FedEx delivered today, and yep. Let's see what we got. Oh, shit. God, I hope she loves this. I hope she even likes it. Okay. And my first attempt at doing a pop art style. My own take, of course. And this was Germantown. I thought it has a cute look. I think she'll like it. There's the koi fish from the pond we love so much. The clock tower on the way in. The wonderful, wonderful scenery. The bushes, the trees, all the reds. And, of course, that wonderful image of Michelle with that hat on, done in a clip art style. I think she'll like this. I like it a lot. Okay.
Another update. I finished Starry Promises. And this is what we have. This is the house we're renting, where I'm going to propose. Hence the painting. But she loves Van Gogh and loves Starry Night. So, hopefully, all goes well. We just picked up Willow from work. That's the week before the train trip, the big day. And Michelle is sitting in the living room out there. And I'm looking at this. Ooh, so excited. 1 week. Okay. So first, I am totally rocking my new outfit I'm going to wear when I propose. Willow loves it because I had to do a fashion show for her. leads me to what I wanted to talk about. We were talking about it in the car when I picked her up from school. And she got so emotional because she was so happy to see me. To see me so happy and so in love. That she just started crying and told me how happy she was, and we hugged, and I cried because she was crying, and it was just a really nice moment. I mean, it's very touching that she worries about me. She said her whole life she thought I deserved somebody like Michelle, and she's just so happy I found her, and so am I.
You can come out.
What?
You can come out.
I don't know where I'm at in this place. Hi. What you doing?
What?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, God. You just gonna have to let me talk.
Okay.
Okay, first. Looks like your old magician still has some tricks up his sleeve. Mm-hmm. I can't do that much. The things I can give you are the things you already have. My soul, all my love, there is something I can give you. I thought I would take you down on a little tour. To some of my favorite memories in our own rooms. First, 14 years ago, right? You really can suspect this from 14 years ago. This is called I Put a Spell on You. And this is this. Now, the lightning in your hand. Your hand?
Mm-hmm.
That is, the status quo, Christy. Cheesy as it's like is to say, it like is real. It happened. And I know that was the universe telling us from day one that this was meant to be. I know we met like in June, but fall's your favorite time of year, right? So I put some artistic questions to it. Okay? Second! This is called Beginnings. This is my interpretation of our first date. Okay. This is us. Out in that snowstorm coming out of that bar.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just blinding in the snow. It was everywhere. And you know, we both thought and said the same thing. So we're finally on a date. It all truly has frozen over. Now you know the cherry blossoms weren't there. But cherry blossoms are indicative of new beginnings, and that's what that night was for me. Very much a new beginning. Well, if you're looking for the mystery door, I didn't forget it.
Oh, God.
Check this out. Door? No.
Oh!
Door, right?
Nice.
Thank you. Oh, good. Yeah, that's okay. Fight night. You got it already. the night you ran chasing the Northern Lights, and you were so sure I was absolutely going to not be okay with it, that it was the most one-sided fight there ever possibly could be. I'm like, what's going on?
Did you hang up on me?
Right? I'm like, no. But, yeah, I hope you know I will always support the things you're passionate about. I hope you definitely know that now. Next. Oh, Germantown. With this. I know you like the pop art style. I know you love the one that hung in the wall in the kitchen. So I did my own interpretation of like pop art, and I did some of my favorite things from Germantown.
Aww.
The koi fish from the pond was so awesome. The clock tower in the wing. All the rich trees took pictures in front of, and it's awesome.
I love it.
Last one. This is called Starry Promises. And I saw that for two reasons. First is at the museum. We stood in front of that Van Gogh painting together and how deeply it hit us. It was very emotional. I promise you, I would paint you your own version of Starry Night. And I made another promise that night. That's the second reason. And I made a promise to myself. And I made a promise that I would do this. So what I want to say is, very simply, I know I can be stubborn. I know I'm stubborn. I know I don't bow down to anybody. But baby, I will always kneel before my queen. I'm not a great man. Not by any stretch. I can't give you a reason. I'm barely a good man, but I am the man who will love you more than anybody possibly does. So, Michelle Frobisher, my name is Dave, my beloved, brother in law. Will you marry me? Thank you.